The SMD magazines have been a solid solution for storing and handling SMD components for years. Since I released the very first prototype back in 2019, over 10,000 magazines have made their way onto workbenches around the world. While the original design held up quite well, I've had a few ideas in mind for how to make it even better. So today I'm excited to introduce the next generation, the SMD Magazines G2. First off, the new version comes in a light color with a deep black print. It's clean, it's functional, and I really like the way it looks. But the biggest upgrade is something many of you have asked for. There's now a wider 16mm version. This means you can now store even wider tapes. Things like connectors, larger ICs, or just those leftover strips that never fit in the original size. The wide magazines can now be combined with the 12mm versions on the same rail. Another really cool upgrade is the improved lever arm. Detaching magazines while feeding components was way too easy. So now there's a small shoulder that prevents accidental removals. You have to intentionally reach past it to detach a magazine. So much better. This shoulder will also give you a proper anchor point for your fingers while advancing the tape. And while we're at it, the new arm is now a little stiffer, which improves locking into those rails with a solid click. I've also addressed an issue with the lid. Sometimes it came off accidentally because it was a bit too loose. The new version uses custom designed print-in-place dowels that now hold the lid in place very firmly. Those turned out so cool and probably deserve an entire YouTube video just about them. But for now, no more accidental lid pop-offs. Next is labeling. It always has been a bit tedious and unclear on how to actually label the magazines. Some of you, including me, have used regular label makers, but it basically takes forever. Others have just handwritten directly onto the magazines, which kind of works okay-ish. A few months ago, I have written a tool that allows you to easily create custom labels. But it requires you to have a cutter, sticker paper, and an actual paper printer, so not very ideal as well. To solve those issues, I'm happy to say that from now on, every pack of magazine comes with this really nice sticker sheet. It's pre-printed and pre-cut. Comes with a full set of three colors for all your resistors, caps, and other components, and has large labels for additional infos. With the magazines, it's all about convenience and speed. Labeling by hand has been the fastest option available. So now it's totally up to you if you write down the full part number, manufacturer, and other things, or just go with the value and footprint. There's no quicker way to do the labeling than this. And now it looks great too. The sticker sheet will be in the magazine packs for free, but you can also purchase them individually if you like to have more of them. With the next generation of SMD magazines, I chose to take things from injection molding back to 3D printing. There were several reasons involved, and I'll probably dedicate an entire video about this topic. But this allows me to be a lot leaner with my production and QA by doing everything back in-house. The new magazines are now heading into production. I'm still waiting for the final packaging and sticker sheets to arrive, but in the meantime, I'm opening up pre-orders with a special early access deal. And if you're getting a pixel pump, the kits have also been updated and now include the new 16mm magazine variant. If you'd like to learn more or reserve yours, just follow the link in the description. I'm really excited to finally share this update with you. It has been in the works for a while, and I can't wait to see what you think. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time, and happy soldering.